Gwen is among the growing numbers of hurting and homeless people that are coming to New Life Evangelistic Center at this time. We're not only going to learn about her, but so many others. So be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. Gwen is among the growing numbers of people that are homeless that are coming to New Life Evangelistic Center. Gwen, years ago, did you ever think when you were a child growing up that you'd end up homeless?
No, sir.
Never thought it could happen to you. How did it happen?
Poor choice decisions, trusting the wrong individuals. And I became expecting with my daughter, which is a teenager now. Mm-hmm. We had a fire in our place, and I didn't expect to have a fire. It was a grease fire. And I ran out to knock on the neighbors' doors because I didn't have a phone. I just got in there. And fortunately, I went back in for two pets that I had and suffered first and second degree burns.
How long ago was that?
Oh, it's been almost, I want to say 20-some years.
So all the way from 20-some years, but you haven't been homeless for 20 years,
have
you?
No, sir.
You lost your place some 20 years ago.
Yes,
but then,
sir.
And since then?
Wind up homeless.
Over the years?
Yes. This,
you found yourself, how did you end up at New Life Evangelistic Center?
Well, my parent used to stay here a long time ago.
Uh-huh.
And she was from the South.
So your parents stayed here, and they've since passed away. You were over in Illinois, I understand,
yes,
right?
Yes, sir. That's
and then
correct.
Through all these things, you found yourself without a place.
Yes, sir.
How long have you been without a place?
For almost 6 months.
6 months now. And you've come to at this time to New Life. You've
yes.
run out of all your options.
That's true.
Can't couch surf anymore from relative to relative.
Exactly.
I mean, people do that for a while. They couch surf, as they refer to it. They stay here, they stay there, and you lost it.
Yes, sir.
Now, we are about ready to see a miracle unfold, and that is a center opening up in Illinois, in Venice, Illinois. So a place first to come be for the homeless men, then the women, the children to come. How important is that place gets open?
Oh, that's very important because we need more outreach programs in the community. Mm-hmm. So nobody else winds up without a place to stay. I think it's very important, and we love
And I'm asking you to pray that could happen by Easter Sunday. With God, all things are possible, that place could be open. Because you see, 30 days before May 12th, they want us, the city of St. Louis wants to start reducing our numbers from 300 to 32. Well, even if we can accommodate 80 over there, it's still going to be a lot. That's why we are going to have to move forward and also pursue all of this through the courts. Because we have a right as a church in a function of worship, it's a provision of shelter. So as we're pursuing in the courts, though, desiring to be good neighbors and knowing that people in downtown St. Louis don't want to see all the people from Illinois coming here, we're opening a shelter in Illinois. And I'm asking you to please pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center that the $75,000 miracle that's needed for that will take place, because it's very, very important that all of you stand with us at this time, because to be homeless, and particularly be a woman that's homeless, that can be quite frightening, can't it?
Yes, Lord, it is.
Have you ever slept outside?
Yes, I did. I found it very difficult.
Was it frightening?
It was. It's scary because I wasn't expecting to find myself having to go outside.
That
ever.
Is really hard, particularly for a woman. So having this place to stay means a whole lot to you?
Yes, Lord. Yes, it does, sir.
All right.
Yes,
well, you can call me Larry.
Yes.
Okay.
Me.
And God bless you. I just want you to know that Jesus loves you, okay?
Thank you so much.
And we want you to know that he got a place for a year because of his people that are sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center. And those who are standing in solidarity with us. What does God want us to do at this time? Micah 6:8. What does he want you to do? To do justly? Yes. Continue to fight for new life, to have the right to shelter the homeless. To love mercy. That is to love the fact that we must help provide directly for the people that are in need and to walk humbly with our God, as Micah 6:8 says. I want to go to Bernie and Don at this particular time as they continue to discuss these issues.
Hi, I'm Bernie Hayes, and with me is Mr. Don Fitz. Don's with the Green Party of the City of St. Louis. Don, welcome.
Well, it's an honor to be talking with Bernie Hayes.
Well, Don, you know, every place I go, I see you. You're an activist, mm-hmm. and I've seen you most recently supporting the New Life Evangelistic
Absolutely.
Center. Especially at the hearings where they tried to take away the license of the New Life Evangelistic Center to house homeless people. They tried to reduce it to only 32 people when there are hundreds of people who need housing. the veterans, the families. What do you feel about that, Don?
I think it's absolutely awful that the city of St. Louis would try to get rid of the only 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week homeless shelter and do that on the final hearing on the 23rd of December, 2 days before Christmas, which seemed like a very calculated move to have a hearing, have an announcement made when people were involved in preparing for Christmas.
You know what distressed me a lot, Don Fitz, is that the people who made those decisions have the very best. They have the best salaries. They have the best insurance plans. They have some of the best homes. Mm-hmm. They're never cold. They have money for gas. They have luxurious cars. But yet and still, they make a decision to take away the shelter of people who are less fortunate than they. How can they do that? In my opinion, what do you think, Don?
And it's amazing to me that when people live away from the problems that ordinary people feel, that they just become very cold-hearted in thinking about that, and they become very selfish and think only about themselves, and they just don't like watching somebody disheveled who may not have money for clothes walking down the street, and so they just want to pretend that their problem doesn't exist by pushing homeless people away. And that, to me, that's amazing.
You've been executive of the Green Party here in the city of St. Louis. You have enough on your back, on your plate, to keep you busy. But yet, you still support the New Life Evangelistic Center and the people here and who run the programs. And you have such a wonderful, warm heart for the homeless. Why?
Well, you know, my wife and I first came down to help at the Thanksgiving dinner. I think it was about 10 years ago. And so we have always supported the homeless. We think it's one of the most important things that people can do. People who, when you are out of a job, when you don't have a source of money, when you don't have a place to live, it's, you know, like every American family, not every family, but 90% of families are just one major illness away from homelessness.
Yeah.
Just, you know, 90% of the population can have a very serious illness and the insurance company just tells them, well, we're not going to cover that. We're only going to pay $100,000. You have to pay the other $900,000.
Sure.
And then what do? And you put your house up on the market because you have to. And then you could be driven out of your home. And so, I mean, to take care of the homeless is really taking care of ourselves, because so many of us could become homeless at any time.
And so many people, Don, will only react to a situation such as that when it happens to them.
Absolutely.
But what about those who are watching us now, who are comfortable in their homes, perhaps don't have a lot, but they have something? How can they get involved? Why should they get involved?
Well, I think they should get involved because humans are part of a community. You know, you can't grow up unless you're part of a society. And a society is a group of people who take care of each other. And so you're really cut to not help take care of the homeless is to really cut yourself off from your society, from an essential part of the society, from the people who are having the hardest difficulty surviving in that society. Everybody is really part of the human family. And so if we say that we're not going to be concerned about these particular people because, you know, they're in a situation I don't think I'll ever be in, you know, you're not really being a responsible citizen.
But how do you, Reverend Rice, how do your wife and other people that I've seen you with go to jail for these people? Why do you put yourself through that?
Well, I haven't actually gone to jail since the Vietnam War. I was in jail during the Vietnam War.
But I know that you're protesting.
Right, and a lot of people are willing to go to jail around the homeless issue.
Sure.
But I think that is one of the ways to really dramatize how serious of a problem this is, and how the city and the state of Missouri cannot afford to ignore it, because the people who understand how serious it is are not going to just look the other way. Mm-hmm. And so going to jail, as Larry Rice has done many times, you know, I think that's an important way to dramatize the seriousness of the problem.
You're also on the ground in Ferguson. Tell us why.
Well, that is something which is a 500-year-old problem. It's a problem that started out with the first slave ship that went to Africa, and the brutality against any people, whether it's black people being brought in as slaves. I grew up in Texas, an area which used to be entirely Hispanic until Anglos moved into the area and drove Spanish-speaking people out of the farmland and took the farmland over for them. So any sort of brutality, against any other human being is something that all of us have to stand against. And it, and Ferguson and Shaw neighborhood of Michael Brown sure. getting killed and Von Derrick Myers getting killed, both of those were clear examples where the policeman doing that should have been indicted immediately. There's overwhelming evidence of a crime of murder being committed, and basically the police departments and the public officials stood behind the police and said, whenever you want to kill a black person, you know, you can get away with it. And there's story after story of a white person doing something and the police shoot the person's hand, shoot the person's arm.
Sure.
Or they can talk. I read a story about a white woman who had an automatic weapon, and the police talked her into putting the weapon down.
Yeah.
But it seems like whenever there's an 18 or 19-year-old black person on the street, the police react immediately by killing him.
Or
seriously injuring the person. And they know that the prosecuting attorney and the politicians are going to be behind them. Right. And so this is one of the most horribly unjust situations that we've seen in America. It's basically a continuation of slavery and Jim Crow and lynchings and all of the discrimination that we've seen for 500 years.
And we've seen Reverend Rice out on the forefront
Absolutely.
Of all these issues. You know, the New Life Evangelic Center, that they need help. They need people to come and volunteers. And you've been volunteering. You and your wife have volunteered here. And I want to know, what it would take to convince the people who are watching us now, those who don't come down, those who don't volunteer, those who don't donate, what's the importance of keeping the shelter open, keeping this New Life Evangelic Center open? What's the importance of keeping these programs going?
The importance of these programs is that they serve the people who are the most disenfranchised in American society, people who don't have a place to live. That gets at your basic rights. And of course, a lot of the people here have a very difficult time with medical care, affording prescriptions, going through the maze of government regulations in order to get medical care and get your prescriptions covered. And so providing New Life as a way to, for a place for people to stay when they don't have a home to live in is really one of the ways to defend the basic American rights. I mean, if you don't have a place to live, what does the Bill of Rights mean? What do the first 10 amendments to the Constitution mean if you don't even have a place to live? And so to me, if you're really defending, your society, then you owe it to your society to defend the people who have been most victimized.
And what would you personally say to Reverend Larry Rice and those people that he ministers to?
I would say you're doing a great job, by going out and defending the rights of the homeless. I know that a lot of homeless people will show up at the demonstrations, at the city council meetings. And people, even though they're really on their down and out, a lot of the people at New Life Evangelistic Center are having the worst experiences of their lives, yet still a lot of people are out there defending the New Life Evangelistic Center. So I hope that everybody viewing will do the same thing.
And they're often stigmatized too, but there are some good people here, people who've been in wonderful positions in life.
Yes.
I mean, they've had very good, well experiences, and some people just down and out on their luck. What would you say to them?
I'd say there are so many examples of people who have been down on their luck, become homeless, and then pull through and do much, much better, that you can too. Keep the faith, because there's no question that there's thousands or millions of examples of people who have gone through things just like what you're going through and have improved their life enormously if they believe that they can. And so that belief that you can is really, really powerful.
Thank you, Don Fitz. Thank you for visiting with us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity to talk about this very important issue.
And we thank you for watching too, and we hope that you'll continue to support Reverend Larry Rice and the ministers here at the New Life Evangelistic Center.
New Life Evangelistic Center is going to continue to serve God and to help those that are in need, and we must stand steadfast at this time, and that's why your prayers and gifts are so very important at this time for our Legal Defense Fund, as well as to open a new facility in Illinois and keep the one at 1411 Locust open at the same time. I have with me a special guest. Go ahead and tell him your name again.
Miss Gwenna Allen.
Okay. And Gwenna, we were talking a little earlier about how difficult it is to be a woman and to experience homelessness.
Yes.
A lot of people, unless they've encountered that, really don't understand, do they?
No, they don't.
How hard is it to find a place when you're a woman and you're homeless?
Oh, it's very hard. I'm trying to seek another job, and that's hard. It's starting over and being without vehicles, a way to get around, and learning directions. It's kind of difficult.
How important is it to keep New Life Evangelistic Center open?
Very important. It's very, very important. I pray that everyone comes in and give more petitions to help keep it open. So a lot of nice women with children and men won't have to go through that and endure that.
And yes, we do thank God for those that are standing with us at this very critical hour. I'd like to go to Kamal and Linda.
We are here with
Linda Ford.
And why did you come out today on this Dr. King Celebration Day? We down here at the old courthouse. And what made you come out today?
Well, Mike Brown got killed, and you know, they are killing young brothers, and I got a 19-year-old. Okay, so. Yeah. It's time for us. I went to see the movie Selma, and it was like we still in the same stage. We haven't moved any further.
Yeah.
So I just came out for that. And as far as Larry Rice, I always give to him. I got some clothes in my car now for him.
And we know that, speaking of Reverend Larry Rice, we know that the city of St. Louis has decided to pull the permit. At this current time, New Life Evangelist Center is able to house over 300 people every night. Those numbers have to be reduced to 32. What would you say to the general public, the need to keep Reverend Larry Rice permit to be able to house over 300 people?
Well, whatever the vote is that we need to put in, because you know what he has done, even though those homeless people are down in that area, he has done great things for homeless people. And why should you have homeless people and everybody is rich? So you need somebody to take charge, and he has done a great thing to me.
Okay, and then also too, in light of Black History season, we know that we're celebrating Dr. King's Day. What would you like to see the city of St. Louis a year or years into the future?
First of all, we need to do some education on these police officers. We definitely need some education with them, because to just go out and kill people and then to get away with it is a murder to me.
I'm back with Gwenna. And Gwenna, you want to get involved in the transitional housing program here at New Life Evangelistic Center. This is where individuals that were homeless get in a training program. You talk, we work closely with our case managers, okay?
Yes, sir.
Martha and Connie, and they help you actually get into a place of your own. Is that why you want to get in the transitional housing program?
Yes.
You've been in it just a short period of time. Have you found it helpful?
Yes, I have. Everybody's very helpful. They're very wonderful to work with. I said most of us should be very thankful, because it helps us to better our lives and stay focused and keep the faith in the Lord.
Do you feel like you're drawing closer to Jesus through all this?
I really do.
Because it's a holistic program. We don't just deal with, as important as it is, the physical needs, the mental needs, but also the spiritual needs. How do you feel it's helping draw closer to God?
We have Bible study every day. Mm-hmm. It's just a blessing, because I know sometimes when you don't have another church home to go to, that's always helpful for us to keep the Lord in your life and ask in Jesus' name for whatever you need. He supplies our needs.
He does. And it is a holistic program. And I'm thanking God for all of you that are remembering New Life Evangelistic Center at this time in your prayers and in your giving. And I'm asking you to continue to pray for that $75,000 Easter miracle so we can open the shelter in Illinois. And I just ask you to stand with us in prayer at this time. We just really praise God for what has been done there. This is a former school building, excellent roof. It's in great structural condition. It's got a great parking lot, but there needs to be totally new plumbing done there. So we're asking you just to believe God for the $75,000. That's to be used to acquire the facility and redo the plumbing there. And already on the front lines, we have Pastor David and Carrie Hale and volunteers they've had work with them that have gone in there and cleaned the place up and done such a tremendous work. And they're going to be helping to coordinate that work. So I'm asking you just continue to pray for us at this time, as New Life Evangelistic Center is determined to stand steadfast in St. Louis also and continue to keep its doors open there and continue to shelter the homeless throughout Missouri at that facility and those in Illinois at the new facility. So please continue to keep that in prayer. And I thank God for those of you that are standing with us at this time.
I'm a lifelong resident of the city of St. Louis. At this particular time, I'd like to thank the Reverend Larry Rice for keeping the doors of the New Life Evangelistic Center open for guys like me and other people, families in need. The occupancy hotel situation is being dealt with in the courts. However, I like to state on record that I support Reverend Rice and the work that he do in the city of St. Louis. We need more homeless services for the homeless in the state of Missouri as well as the city of St. Louis. And we would like for those who are thoughtful-minded people to continue to support Reverend Rice and continue to give your donations to those, because these resources are being used to help a lot of people in the city of St. Louis. We certainly look forward to a favorable ruling by the courts in order for the doors of the New Life Evangelistic Center to be able to stay open and help those that are in need. Thank you, and have a blessed day.
I would thank God for the churches that are helping people that are in need. Many churches are doing wonderful programs and putting people in hotels, but that can get to be quite expensive. And that's why we definitely need to try to keep the New Life Evangelistic Center open here. I was sharing with people about how the whole last year we'd spent like $120,000 on legal expenses, and people would say, well, that's a lot of money. Not when you stop and think that if we had to put them in hotels at $30 a night, 300 people, $9,000 a night times, what would that be? 300 people at $30 a night, that would be like a $9,000. That's a lot of money, okay? But it'd add up pretty quick, okay? So we're asking you to pray and see how much we are saving, then multiply that times 30 nights, that's $270,000. So it's much easier for us to fight to keep New Life Evangelistic Center open. And I have with me a brotherhood, a church that actually, praise God, put him up for 30 days in a hotel, the time run out there. And he ended up coming to New Life Evangelistic Center, and just wasn't any other major walk-in shelter for him to come to. Tell us your name.
Michael Wright.
And Michael, why is this transitional housing program particularly important to you now?
Well, it's an immediate source of being out of the elements. We're in the winter now, which even though right now this weather is okay, but still it's winter, and I don't have to deal with...
What's it going to take to help get you back on your feet?
Focus, opportunity, and just being steadfast and applying myself and taking advantage of the doors that God opens.
And God is opening some doors for you.
Absolutely.
Now.
Absolutely.
He's part of a transitional housing program here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And yes, we must keep New Life open, and that will happen as you continue to pray and share with us. And what a blessing and encouragement it is when people are, come forth, like Vivian does, and talk about how important it is that New Life stays open, as she shares with Kamal.
I'm out here with Vivian Brown, and you've been a longtime activist and also a supporter of Reverend Larry Rice.
Right.
Why are you out here today? What does Dr. King and the march mean to you?
Well, it means a lot. It means that we continue to do the peaceness in life, that we continue that we have justice in different situations, just like the Ferguson problem. We got to continue to march no matter what goes on. We got to continue to fight no matter what goes on, because racism is always going to be there. So what we got to do, we got to stay on it. And that's what's important to me, because Martin Luther King went through many marches with many different people, just so that we are able to walk not only all over this universe, but right here in St. Louis.
We see many issues in the city of St. Louis, from Mike Brown to Rem Rice having his hotel permit pulled, where they want the numbers to decrease by 90%. I mean, what would you say to have the need to have Rem Rice and to have walk-in shelters?
I think he should continue to do what he do and try to do the best thing. You know, they always want to try to pull the person that's really trying to do something.
Right.
And we know sometimes the people that work or volunteer for them don't always do the right thing.
Right.
And this can cause problems. But I'm with him. Whatever he's trying to do, we're with him.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, thank you, Vivian.
You're welcome. Anytime. Okay. Thank you all.
As a society, we must keep our priorities straight, and that is help those that are hurting, those that are homeless. That's what Jesus told us to do.
That's right.
We live in a society where St. Louis County leaders, state leader, and mayor would say it's important to build a football stadium to keep the Rams, But what about shelter for the homeless? We need to get our priorities straight at this time, would you not say?
Absolutely.
Right. You're experiencing what it's like being homeless.
Absolutely.
When you hear those kind of discussions, how does that make you feel? They're talking about building a football stadium and the homeless are all around us, and they try to stop New Life from helping those that are hurting?
It makes me feel like America has lost its love and moral compass.
Yes.
Priorities are totally headed in the wrong direction.
That is. And we need to pray. We need to pray this community repents and just really gets back and close to God. I want to go to Keith and Mike at this time as they express their opinion on that issue.
There is or should be a place at the table for everyone, no matter what the color, no matter what the class. There should be a place at the table for everyone. And when the place at the table next to me is empty, I need to speak and lift my brother up who should be at that table. And part of that is the homeless veterans that are here in this area. People like us, we need to speak up. We need to do more as it relates to the homeless veterans.
It kind of hurts me being a veteran to see some people who don't have opportunity once you serve this country. Listening to our mayor saying that we're about to put this $1 million stadium up, yet we have 85% veterans that are here in Missouri that are living out of tents, and we can't even provide a building for them to survive in. It's kind of upsetting to me because I know the opportunities that I've had by having my parents in my life, as well as being in these great organizations that I'm in that support everything that I do. So it's kind of upsetting to know that you do have some Americans that are behind them. You do have some St. Louisans that are behind the veterans, but it's not a lot of push. Like he said, I do a Thanksgiving dinner every year, and my fraternities are involved. And we not only just try to reach the homeless, we try to reach the sick and shut-in for those who cannot get out. And this year, we fed over 250 people. We clothed over 200. So as we do a small part, we would hope that other people will just come in and try to help out so we can actually just get to the bottom of what's going on and try to create some situations and resources for people that really need them instead of we going out spending millions on a dome that we really don't need.
Our veterans are out on the streets right now. And that's why I'm asking you to please continue to help New Life Evangelistic Center to keep its doors open to the women, to the veterans, to the hurting, to the homeless. Because literally, there's not that many places people can walk into in the middle of the night, is there?
No. No. And not be welcome.
Yeah. Just I mean, you can't go knock on a door or just can't sleep in a park. You can't curl up in front of a building. I mean, what would happen if New Life Evangelistic Center was not open?
I believe it would be tragic. I believe a lot of people, and I'm not trying to say anything against our mm-hmm. police or judicial system, but it could be target practice.
It could be. Uh-huh.
You know,
the war on
there
poverty.
Is a lot of adversity, antagonistic, elements out there. And without a refuge that God has provided through ministries as sensitive to God's heart, because we know Christ talked about, even in the Beatitudes, his focus a lot of times was on poor. Mm-hmm. And that's, I don't know many rich people that are homeless, so.
And Jesus, could he identify it even further when he said that foxes have holes and birds have nests, but he, the Son of Man, had nowhere to lay his head? And when he said, when I was hungry, did you feed me? Totally identify with hungry.
Absolutely.
Naked, did you clothe me? Sick or in prison, visit me? Stranger, homeless, did you welcome me? As often as you've done to the least of these, he said, even so you've done it to me.
Amen.
But he showed us what he wants us to do right now.
Amen.
The fact is, we need to get busy and start doing it. And we give you that opportunity here at New Life Evangelistic Center. I want to encourage you to go to www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org and see all the opportunities awaiting you there. I ask you to pray for the new shelter we want to open in Illinois by Easter. Please pray for that endeavor, and we welcome you to come and join the volunteers, and let's get it done. And I'm asking you to please partner with New Life Evangelistic Center to help us meet some of the tremendous financial needs we're facing at this time. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. Thank you for caring and sharing at this time.